We are the personal connection between the artist, the artwork, and the buyer. The gallery started on an island on the west coast. A small island where there's only like 3,500 people. And the gallery wasn't necessary for us to sell. We were just doing shows, and we were also working with Scandinavian design. Working with both design and art at that time was a little bit tricky because the art didn't get the necessary focus. The challenges is really that you're both the economy director, you're the guy who's hanging the work up, you're the guy trying to find the artists, you're painting the walls when the exhibition is finished, and even though we have a little bit of help, you're still, you know, you're doing, you have 360 degrees. And I mean, it's exciting to sort of follow these projects that we've chosen to work with. We're a part of the development of them. We don't do the work, but we're the dialogue between the artists and ourselves, I find very inspiring, and the curating of the shows I find very exciting. And art fairs are a way today of meeting both new clients but also looking after clients. It's a way of exposing the artists internationally. I enjoy it. I'm a real sort of art fair addict. I like art fairs. I like the preparation up to art fairs. I like the intensity there is in the fair. The current exhibition is with an artist that we've been working with since 2010, Asmund Halstein Mikkelsen. He's very interested in buildings from the modernist period, or how modernism has influenced both architecture but also contemporary culture. And I think it's very important to have a gallery space. I think the space of a gallery, the physical room, the focus 100% on a certain curation or an exhibition is also a way of making a statement which is very, very difficult for the artist to do otherwise.